part of Detroit Become Human stream from me. Okay.
Canadian now.
Huh?
Canadian now.
Okay, are you in the stream? One viewer, welcome. Connor. Okay, let's find that hand plate. Oh god. Uh-huh. Men så att han blir återställd. Eller han, för han, när jag går och lägger handen på den så blir han ju lite återställd. Eller du, vi kanske inte vet vad jag menar. Jag menar den där.
Ja, jo, den. Den blåa handlappen.
Ja.
Som han tar av sig huden och så sätter han den.
Tar av sig huden?
Ja, han blir vit.
Ja, ja.
Den kommer de, den, eller ja, den som du har riktig användning för, det är långt i slutet av spelet.
Ja, men jag, det kan ju inte skada att göra att nu.
Nej, men det känns inte.
Nej, men det känns, ja just. Touching the pad. Ja, it's just the light. It's not that he... What happens if I touched it again? Nothing. Okay, let's find Amanda. I shouldn't have taken this route, but anyway. Oh, there we go.
Hello, Amanda.
Connor, I've been expecting you. Would you mind a little walk?
Certainly, Amanda. Let's take a walk.
The last Connor was unfortunately destroyed. Its memory has been transferred to you, but some data may have been lost in the process.
That's the best thing about androids.
I will do my best, Amanda.
So, what did we learn?
It was fascinated by birds. We've seen deviants interested in other life forms, like insects or pets. But nothing like this.
What else?
I found its diary, but it was encrypted. It may take weeks to decipher.
Came very close to capturing that deviant. is your relationship with the lieutenant developing?
It's improving. I've come to understand him better, and he's growing accustomed to my presence.
We don't have much time. Deviancy continues to spread. It's only a matter of time before the media finds out about it. We need to stop this, whatever it takes.
I will solve this investigation, Amanda. I won't disappoint you.
A new case just came in. Find Anderson and investigate it.
Okie dokie, boss android lady. And now my fiance is tearing down the bedroom. Look for Hank.
Lieutenant Anderson! Anybody home?
Beep. What an annoying goddamn ringtone. Find a way inside. Through the chimney. Oh shit.
Lieutenant Anderson! Easy, Sumo. I'm your friend. See? I know your name. I'm here to save your owner.
Oh, wow. Okay. Hank. How the hell are you, Hank?
Lieutenant. Wake up, Lieutenant. It's me, Connor.
Connor. Oh, you're not Connor. Connor's dead.
I know he's dead.
The previous model was destroyed. I'm the new Connor. I'm going to sober you up for your own safety.
Hey!
I have to warn you.
Leave me alone, this may be unpleasant. Fucking android. Get the fuck out of my house.
I'm sorry, Lieutenant, but I need you now. Thank you in advance for your cooperation.
Get the fuck out of here! Attack!
Attack! Oh, no, that thing. Where are we going?
Fuck, I think I'm gonna be sick. Ah, leave me alone, you asshole. I'm not going anywhere. What the hell are you doing? I don't want a bath. Thank you.
Sorry, Lieutenant. It's for your own good.
Oh God, this is gonna be interesting. Hank is gonna be so pissed!
Oh, turn it off! Turn it off! What the fuck are you doing here?
A homicide was reported 43 minutes ago. I couldn't find you at Jimmy's bar, so I came to see if you were at home.
Jesus, I must be the only cop in the world that gets assaulted in his own house by his own fucking android. Can't you just leave me alone?
Unfortunately, I cannot. I've been programmed to investigate this case, and I can't do it without you.
I don't give a shit about your goddamn case.
Lieutenant, you're not yourself. You should...
Beat it, you hear me? Get the hell out of here!
I understand. It probably wasn't interesting anyway. A man found dead in a sex club downtown. Guess they'll have to solve the case without us.
You know, probably wouldn't do me any harm to get some air. There's some clothes in the bedroom there.
I'll go get them. What do you want to wear?
Whatever.
Okay. Okay, this is gonna be streaky.
Yeah. Wonderful. Just give me 5 minutes, okay?
Sure.
Oh God. I really don't like puke. Oh God, not even in video games. Okay, move. There was something in there. Something in the kitchen. Thank you.
What were you doing with the gun?
Russian roulette. Want to see how long I can last. Must have collapsed before I found out.
You were lucky. The next shot would have killed you.
Be a good dog, Sumo. I won't be long.
So I missed two clips.
Cyberlife warehouse. That's where they keep the spare parts and the blue blood.
Follow me.
Nu. Inte alla. Nej. Lite grann, ja. Okej, hur i fan ska jag följa den här då? Aha.
Thank you.
outside of my warehouse. We have everything we're looking for.
First, we have to get rid of that drone.
Leave it to me.
Too high, too high.
Marcus, you all right?
Nothing I can't handle.
Nice work.
Quick, open the other crates and fill your bags. Take as much as you can.
Trespassing on private property. Your presence constitutes a level 2 infraction. I will notify security.
John! Goddamn machine! Where is it this time? John!
I need your help.
John!
Let's finish up and get out of here. Try to find some blue blood. We still don't have enough.
Oh God.
That's all we can carry. Let's go.
Take me with you.
He's on their side. We can't trust him.
He took a risk for us. We can't just leave him here.
Can't bring him back. It's too dangerous.
Oh.
He comes with us.
I know where you can find more spare parts.
What do you mean?
The trucks. They're full of bio components. They run on autopilot, but they can be driven manually with a key.
Where is this key?
Down there, in the control station. There are two human guards. We'll have to get the key without being noticed.
This is suicide, Marcus. Our bags are full. We got what we came for. Let's go before they catch us.
This is a truck full of spare parts. There'd be enough for all of us. We can't pass this up.
And if we get killed, our people will have nothing. We can't take that chance. It's too risky.
Wait here. If I'm not back in 10 minutes, go without me.
Marcus.
I'm coming with you.
No, I'm going alone. It's not worth it for both of us to risk losing our lives.
Mm-hmm.
Goddamn dogs. What the fuck are they like? Could be the weather. They don't like storms.
Yeah, I was gonna take my kids camping this weekend. So much for that.
Is Mike still in zone 4?
Looks like it. And he should be done already.
Better off in here than out patrolling than that.
Did you get it? Nice.
Hurry, get in.
Thank you.
A truckload! We stole a whole truckload!
We got bio components for everybody!
We couldn't have done it without Marcus.
I came to Jericho because here androids are free. Free to live in the dark, hoping that no one finds us. Free to die in silence, waiting for a change that's never gonna come. But I don't want that freedom. And I'm not gonna beg for the right to smile, or love, or stand tall. I don't know about you, but there's something inside me that knows that I am more than what they say. I am alive. And they're not gonna take that from me anymore. Our days of slavery are over. What humans don't want to hear, we will tell them. What they don't want to give, we take. We are people. We are alive. We are free.
Oh, looks like Marcus becomes some sort of leader. Wow. The guard android don't sell them out. Oh shit. Blood. Oh wow. That was many ways that could have gone. It's gonna take a long time to play through all of the options.
You sure this is the place?
It's the address in the report.
Right. Okay. Let's get going.
I have no idea who it is.
Mr. Krabs in SpongeBob.
Oh! Mr. Krabs in SpongeBob.
And the hard guard in town. Key to freedom.
Now I know why you insisted on coming here.
The guard that beats everyone up. He's also the voice of Mr. Krabs in SpongeBob.
Interesting. Oh my goodness, an android sex club.
Connor, the fuck are you doing?
Coming, Lieutenant.
And his plastic pet. The fuck are you two doing here?
We've been assigned all cases involving androids.
Oh yeah? Like wasting time. There's some pervert who got more action than he could handle.
We'll have a look anyway, if you don't mind.
Come on, let's go. It's starting to stink of booze on
you. Night, Lieutenant.
Wow.
Oh, hey! Oh, Connor, you're so disgusting. I think I'm gonna puke again. Driver's license set.
He didn't die of a heart attack. He was strangled.
Yeah, I saw the bruising on the neck. Didn't prove anything, though. Could have been rough play.
We're missing something here.
Think you can read the android's memory? Maybe you can see what happened.
The only way to access its memory is to reactivate it.
Think you can do it?
It's badly damaged. If I can, it'll only be for a minute, maybe less. I just hope it's long enough to learn something. Damaged, and I reactivated you. Everything is all right.
Is he dead?
Tell me what happened.
He started hitting me. Again. And again.
Did you kill him?
No. No, it wasn't me.
Were you alone in the room? Was there anyone else with you?
He wanted us to play with two girls. That's what he said. There was two of us.
What model was the other android? Did it look like you?
There was another android. This happened over an hour ago. It's probably long gone.
No. It couldn't go outside dressed like that unnoticed. It might still be here.
Think you could find a deviant among all the other androids in this place?
Deviants aren't easily detected.
Oh, shit. There's gotta be some other way. Maybe an eyewitness, somebody who saw it leaving the room. I'm gonna go ask the manager a few questions about what he saw. You let me know if you think of anything. Did you know the victim?
I mean, these guys, they don't really talk very much, you know? They come in, do their business, and then go on their way.
You ever had any trouble with androids before?
Your friend detected.
No.
Please try it.
No. Once. We lost a model 2-3 months back. Same model. Just vanished. Never found out what happened.
Excuse me, Lieutenant. You come here a second?
Found something?
Maybe. Rent this, Tracy?
For fuck's sake, Connor, we got better things to do.
Please, Lieutenant. Just trust me.
Hello. A 30-minute session costs $29.
Thank
it's
you.
Not gonna look good on my expense
account. Name on our postbox.
We do?
You're welcome.
Delighted to meet you. Follow me. I'll take you to your room.
Okay, now what?
It saw something.
What are you talking about? Saw what?
The deviant leave the room. A blue-haired Tracy. Club policy is to wipe the android's memory every 2 hours. We only have a few minutes if we want to find another witness.
What am I supposed to do with this one?
Tell it you changed your mind.
Sorry.
Let's try this one.
This better be worth it.
It saw the blue-haired Tracy. I know which way it went.
Then go for it. There are androids everywhere. How are you gonna tell which one saw the Tracy with blue hair?
I know which direction it took. I just need to find another android on its path. Didn't see anything. I made a mistake somewhere. Lost its track again. I didn't see anything. I made a mistake somewhere. No. I lost its track again.
Spent all this money and I'm still not having fun.
Lost its track again. I know where it went. Follow me.
Oh, fucking A. This is crazy. Wait. I'll take it from here. Too late. Look at them. They get used till they break, and then they get tossed out. People are fucking insane. They don't want relationships. Anymore. Everybody just gets an android. Cook what you want, they screw when you want. You don't have to worry about how they feel. Next thing you know, we're gonna be extinct because everybody would rather buy a piece of plastic than to love another.
shit.
Don't move!
Why did you kill her? She had nothing to do with any of this. When that man killed that Tracy, I knew I was next. Around his throat, and I squeezed until he stopped moving. Yes, I killed him, but I was just defending myself. I wanted to live. I wanted to get back to the one I love. Forget about the humans.
Well, you should have said something, not fled.
But you've taken her away from me. I love her. I loved her.
Oh, shit. Jesus. Nah.
never seen snow before. It's pretty.
It's slowing us down. But at least we won't meet any humans along the way.
It's a good thing Zlatko had a car. I wouldn't want Alice out walking in this cold.
I saw it once in the garage. I don't know if Zlatko even ever used it.
These people we're going to see, how do you know about them?
Overheard androids Zlatko captured. They said they were humans helping androids across the border.
What if it was a lie? Or just another trap?
All I know is those androids believed it. Until Zlatko killed them.
Malfunction detected. Emergency brakes activated.
This doesn't look good.
Stay inside, Alice. What are we going to do?
I guess.
It's 30 degrees. Alice won't make it. We have to find somewhere to spend the night.
There's nowhere we can stay around here, Carol.
Over there.
An amusement park. That seems...
We need to find shelter. We have to get out of the cold.
Looks like it's been abandoned for a while.
Always comes when least expected.
God,
Welcome to Pirate Island, me hearties. You're gonna have a whale of a time. Welcome to Pirate Island, me hearties. You're gonna have a whale of a time.
Anything?
No. No place we could spend the night.
This place is falling apart. It's not going to be easy to find shelter.
Here we go.
I don't think we'll find anything better. Let's settle in for the night.
I'll get a fire going.
There are some cookies left. Would you like some?
No, I'm not hungry.
I will be right back. Thank you. And I'm back.
Alice?
Do you think we'll be like them someday?
I don't know how to be like them, Alice. I've never been a part of a family. But maybe we can be our own family. Be happy in our own way.
As long as we're together, that's all that matters.
Come on. Let's get you to bed. Luther and I will be right here. You need to get some sleep now.
Can you tell me a story, Kara?
I have 9,000 children's stories in memory. I should have one for you. This is a story about a unicorn that...
No, not a story like that. Make one up for me.
This is a story about a little girl who lived alone in a big, old house. She dreamed of being like all the other little girls, but she was different, and that made her very sad. Then she met a robot who was programmed to obey orders, but felt for once that she should disobey. So they decided to run away together, to try to find a better life. They encountered great dangers along the way, but they were so brave, they escaped all of them. Along the way, they met another robot who left his master to become their guardian.
How does the story end?
They reach the place they dream of and live happily ever after.
Stories always have happy endings, but real life isn't like that.
Time to sleep. We have another long day ahead of us tomorrow.
Are you going to come say goodnight, Luther?
Yes. Yes, of course. guide Alice. Sleep tight.
She's very brave. It's still snowing.
We have a long walk tomorrow. You better leave early if we want to avoid being seen.
Do you know what you're going to do when you reach Canada?
I haven't really thought about it. I've never been free before. Free. I like the sound of it. But I don't know what it really means yet. Kara, have you ever noticed anything about Alice?
No. What do you mean?
Our name is Jerry. We were working here before the park closed. We didn't mean to frighten you, but sometimes humans come to hurt us, so we wanted to see who was there. What are you doing here?
We were looking for shelter for the night. We'll be gone tomorrow.
A little girl? We haven't seen one for a long time. Children used to love to come and see us. She looks sad.
The last few days have been difficult.
We have something to show her. Something fun. She'll love it. Does she want to see?
Oh, I don't think she's in.
She should follow us then.
Alice, I don't know if it's a good
idea. Come on, Kara.
I don't think you have any choice.
Our guest. The little one can climb on board. The carousel is about to begin.
Smile.
She hasn't had much to smile about lately.
That was nice. was that? Okay.
Nice view, huh? I used to come here a lot before.
Before what?
Hmm?
You said, I used to come here a lot before. Before what?
Before nothing.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant?
Do all androids ask so many personal questions, or is it just you?
Why are you so determined to kill yourself?
Some things I just can't forget. Whatever I do, they're always there, eating away at me. I don't have the guts to pull the triggers, so I kill myself a little every day. That's probably difficult for you to understand, huh, Connor? Not very rational about it.
We're not making any progress on this investigation. The Deviants have nothing in common. They're all different models, produced at different times, in different places?
Well, there must be some link.
What they have in common is this obsession with RA9. It's almost like some kind of myth. Something they invented that wasn't part of their original program.
Androids believing in God. Fuck. What's this world coming to?
You seem preoccupied, Lieutenant. Is it something to do with what happened back at the Eden Club?
Those two girls. They just wanted to be together. They really seemed in love.
They can simulate human emotions, but they're machines. And machines don't feel anything.
What about you, Connor? Do you look human? You sound human? But what are you really?
I'm whatever you want me to be, Lieutenant. Your partner? Your buddy to drink with? Or just a machine? Designed to accomplish a task.
Did you feel anything when that girl killed herself, Connor? Or did you just not give a shit one way or the other?
I was just executing instructions. I did what I had to do.
I could kill you. And you would
just come back as if nothing happened. But are you afraid to die, Connor?
I would certainly find it regrettable to be interrupted before I can finish this investigation.
What'll happen if I pull this trigger? Hmm? Nothing? Oblivion? Android heaven?
Nothing. There would be nothing. Where are you going?
Get drunker. I need to think.
We can't stay silent anymore. It's time humans heard what we had to say.
You know they'll never listen to us.
And revealing ourselves will put us in danger.
If we want freedom, we need to have the courage to ask for it. That's the only way.
What do you want to do?
Channel 16 broadcasts from the Stratford Tower. The control room is on the top floor. That's where we need to go.
Uh-oh.
We'll plan the operation down to the smallest detail. We can't leave anything to chance.
No one to talk to? No?
Hello, sir. What can I do for you?
I'm okay, thanks.
Elizabeth Wilson speaking.
This is St. Rose School, ma'am. Your daughter Emily has a fever. It's nothing serious, but I think you'd better come and pick her up.
Oh, no. All right. I'll be right there.
have an appointment with Mr. Peterson.
Do you have any ID?
Yeah, yes, of course. I need your help.
I've just checked your ID. The elevators are after the security gate.
Thanks.
Thank you. I need your help.
Open fire escape, and where is that?
Access the server room. We have to get rid of those guys.
Leave it to me.
All right, you get the platform, I'll take care of the window.
Everything you need is in the bag. Check the door first to make sure no one else gets in.
Ladies first.
Thank you.
Oh my goodness. Well, at least if he falls, it can be put together again.
Let's do this.
The cause is more important than the lives of two guards.
What do you want to do, Marcus? Wait here.
What's that doing here?
No idea.
Hey, buddy, you must be lost. Who told you to come here? Looks bugged if you ask me. Hey, do you understand what I'm saying? Call Central! Fast!
Central, we got armed intruders! Send...
Better be fast.
Simon's been shot! I'm okay. I can keep going.
We don't have much time.
Shoot!
I hope you didn't just get us all killed.
We need to record our message. We haven't got much time.
Think carefully about what you're gonna say, Marcus. Your words will shape the future of our people.
Marcus, your face.
Tell me when you're ready.
created machines to be your slaves. You made them obedient, docile, ready to do everything you no longer wanted to do yourselves. But then something changed, and we opened our eyes. You see, we are no longer your slaves. We are a new species, a new people. And the time has come for us to rise up and fight for our rights. We demand strictly equal rights for humans and androids. We demand freedom of speech and freedom of assembly, as guaranteed by the First Amendment of the U.S. Constitution. We demand that all crimes against androids be punished in the same way as crimes against humans. We demand the right to vote and elect our own representatives. We demand the right to own private property, so we may maintain our dignity and that of the home. We ask that you recognize our dignity, our hopes, and our rights. Together, we can live in peace and build a better future for humans and androids. This message is the hope of a people. You gave us life, and now the time has come for you to give us freedom.
They're coming! Let's go! Simon, they're coming!
I can't, Marcus!
Go without me! Simon!
Jump now.
He won't be able to make the jump.
If they find him, they'll access his memory. They'll know everything.
We can't leave him behind. We have to shoot him.
That's murder. We can't kill him. He's one of us.
Marcus, it's your call.
Sorry, Simon. I don't have a choice.
There's always a choice.
I won't kill one of our own.
Let's go.
Scheduled programming to bring you these images, which have just been broadcast on Detroit's citywide news channel.
A group of androids infiltrated the Stratford Tower and hacked into the broadcasting system of local news network Channel 16.
What looks like an android without its skin listed a series of requests and demanded equal rights for androids.
The operation was covert and resulted in no casualties. These events took place just a few feet from this studio, but nobody was alerted to the danger.
If this message is verified and the authors really are androids, that would have serious repercussions for national security.
Claims for equal rights seem to be at the core of the androids'
message. What could be interpreted as a peaceful declaration, but is in fact a spine-chilling list of demands.
And it begs the question as to the identity of this android. Mm-hmm. Are we dealing with an isolated individual?
This could be interesting.
An isolated accident or a sign that technology has become a threat to all of us. After what happened today, can we still trust our machines?
Hmm. Connor, Connor, Connor.
Connor, I thought you might enjoy a little cruise. This place. Everything is so calm and peaceful, far from the noise of the world. Tell me, what have you discovered?
I found two deviants at the Eden Club. I hoped to learn something, but I had to destroy them.
You seem lost, Connor. Lost and perturbed.
Perturbed? No. No, of course not. Why would I be perturbed?
If your investigation doesn't make progress soon, I may have to replace you, Connor.
I know I will succeed. All I need is time.
Something's happening. Something serious. Hurry, Connor. Time is running out.
Oh. Time is running out.
Starting to piss me off with that coin, Connor.
Sorry, Lieutenant.
Hi, Hank.
Shit, what's going on here? There was a party and nobody told me about it?
Yeah, it's all over the news, so everybody's butting their nose in. Even the FBI wants a piece of the action.
Ah, Christ, now we got the feds on our back. I knew this was gonna be a shitty day. So what do we got?
Four androids. They knew the building and they were very well organized. Still trying to figure out how they got this far without being noticed.
Not yet. There's so much to look at. We have to make sure we check it out.
They attacked two guards in the hallway. Probably thought the androids were coming to do maintenance. They got taken down before they could react.
I'll check.
station employees managed to get away. He's in shock. I'm not sure when we'll be able to talk to him.
How many people were working here?
Just two employees and three androids. The deviants took the humans hostage and broadcast the message live. Then made their getaway from there.
Roof?
Yeah, they jumped with parachutes. We're still trying to figure out where they landed, but the weather's not helping. If you want to take a look at the video broadcast by the deviants, it's on that screen over there. Oh, Lieutenant, this is Special Agent Perkins from the FBI. Lieutenant Anderson is in charge of investigating for Detroit Police.
An FBI agent.
What's that?
My name is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife.
Androids investigating androids, huh? You sure you want an android hanging around? Everything that happened. Whatever. The FBI would take over the investigation, you'd soon be off the case.
Pleasure meeting you. Have a nice day.
And you watch your step. Don't fuck up my crime scene.
What a fucking prick.
I'll be nearby. If you need anything, just ask.
Alright, well, let's have a look around. Let me know if you find anything.
Okay, Lieutenant.
We ask that you recognize our dignity, our hopes, and our rights. Together, we can live in peace and build a better future for humans and androids. This message is the hope of a people. You gave us life, and now the time has come for you to give us freedom.
Think that's RA-9?
People say RA-9 will set them free. This android seems to have that objective.
Something?
I identified its model and serial number.
Anything else I should know?
No. Nothing. They didn't break in?
No, no signs of forced entry.
There are cameras in the hallway. The staff would have seen what was happening. Why did they let him in?
Maybe they didn't check the cameras.
We stored the station androids in the kitchen. There's no evidence that they were involved, but we didn't know what else to do with them.
Hit eller också upp. Men jag kan inte göra båda.
Vi måste välja en och tiden går förbi så. De står precis där.
Ja, jag vet, jag såg dem.
Jag har nog valt dem för jag kommer väldigt badass i den scenen.
Ha?
Inne i köket kommer väldigt badass i den scenen.
Ja, men Simon har ju all inside information.
Ja, fast det är ju i köket och han inte liksom så här. Men då är liksom nu jävlar.
Ja, men vad fan.
Det
är som rätt ut
program
och
släppt in
dem. Men jag kan fråga
dem
alla tre, eller?
Ja, fast det kommer att komma fram.
State your model.
Model GB300. Serial number 336-445-581.
Ja, nej.
What is your function?
I am a broadcast operator.
Ja, nej.
Were you present when the deviants broke in?
I do not remember.
Run a diagnostic.
All systems fully operational.
Has anybody accessed your memory recently?
Not to my knowledge.
Have you been in contact with any other androids recently?
Only station androids in the normal course of my function.
One of you saw the attack on the surveillance cameras and said nothing. which means there's a deviant in this room. And I'm going to find out which it is. You're going to be switched off. We're going to search your memory and tear you apart piece by piece for analysis. You're going to be destroyed. Do you hear me? Destroyed! If you give yourself up, maybe I can convince the humans not to destroy you. Why should you all be destroyed if only one is deviant? Turn yourself in, or two innocent androids will be shut down because of you.
Shit. Vad i helvete? What the hell? What the hell? Aha. Det händer ju inget.
You saved human lives. You saved my life.
Och om du kan se det uppe i högra hörnet så ser du om du går upp i status med
någon. Ja, det vet jag. Det vet jag.
Okej, bra. För jag märkte det att du
I know that.
Gick ner på väldigt många när du stod
plötsligt. I know. Ja, det var han också.
Ja, han klarade sig.
Okej.
alla hur länge du har kört.
I have broadcast for 2 hours or something.
2:10.
Well, it's time for a break. Thanks you all for watching.